Hey guys, welcome to or welcome back to my channel for another ASMR video. Today I'm gonna be doing another ASMR story time. I think the title's gonna be something like College Professor from Hell. And you know, for anyone that's gonna say, because I can already smell the comments, because every single other ASMR story time I've done, I've gotten a comment being like, you're so negative. Excuse me, you're tuning in to a YouTube ASMR, or not YouTube ASMR story time necessarily, but like a YouTube story time, and obviously those kind of things are going to entail drama, and drama is not going to be like a fairy tale. If you're looking for a fairy tale, go to like Disney Channel or something. Like, you probably have better luck finding that there. But yeah, and like these story times are like lighthearted, they're not like serious topics, they're just like stupid things that happen to me. And obviously, like, the people I'm gonna be talking about in a negative way are my ops. I'm not gonna be like complimenting my ops. So yeah, let's get started. Also, I'm gonna be tapping on this like cushion foundation as I'm talking, because like, yeah, I just think just talking is a little bit boring, but let's get started. So this is the professor for my tax class. So I'm currently going through this, like, I am in the trenches with this professor right now. Is the worst, hands down, the worst, most awful professor I've ever had, and I'm in my fall semester of my senior year. So I did the math. I've taken, including the classes I'm taking this semester, 35 college classes, and of course this is not including AP classes that I took in high school. So 35 courses that I took purely in college, and 35 is more than what most college people, like college, oh my god, I can't speak. Is more than what most fall semester seniors take, and that's because like I transfer school, so like some of my credits didn't transfer over, so I had to like make those up, and also I'm double majoring, so like I inherently have more requirements and like more credits to take. So yeah, that's why I've taken 35 classes, and well, okay, 35 not including like one or two credit classes. If we're including like one to two credit, I've taken 37, but 35 like full on 4 credit classes. So yeah, this professor is for my tax class. And to start off, okay, when you're taking class, usually the professor has like a PowerPoint or guided notes, like from my other accounting classes. Sometimes there's lots of calculations, so, and like lots of math to do, so there'll be like a guided notes, and they're like writing down the like how you're doing the problem, and you're like copying it down, so like guided notes in that sense. And this professor has none of that, so he is super old school, which is like not wrong, it's just like really annoying and inconvenient, but he's super old school. He handwrites everything on the board, and his handwriting is awful. It's awful, like it's so hard to understand, and I myself have pretty messy handwriting, so I'm usually pretty good at reading other people's handwriting, but he's just, oh, I have to hear what he's saying, so I write it down in accordance to what I'm like hearing. But if I were to purely just like look at the board, I wouldn't really understand half of what he's like, what half of what's written on there. So he doesn't have like lecture slides, so and he stands in front of the board and like blocks the view a lot of the times, so like I'll be like craning my head and like standing up, and I'm not the only one that does this, but I have to like try to see what he's writing. And he is also really disorganized, so he never, so, okay, he doesn't say, like, hey, we're on chapter 14, and, like, we're gonna be talking about chapter 14 right now, and then, like, when he's done talking about that, say it's, like, halfway through the class, he doesn't say, okay, now I'm moving on to chapter 15, he just, like, is yapping, and it's not until I read the textbook myself, and, like, corroborate between what I'm reading and, like, what I had written down able to be like, okay, this is the information from this chapter, and this is the information from this chapter. And on that note, he doesn't teach. He, like, he's awful at teaching, and, okay, because he doesn't teach, this is, like, the first class that I've had to actually crack open the textbook. I know some majors are probably gonna hate me for saying this, but this is the first time I've ever read the textbook in college, ever. Like, for all my classes, I've taken plenty of hard classes. professors so far. I've had plenty where they aren't great at teaching, and before anyone comes for me, I'm not the type of person that isn't willing to put in the hard work, like for all my classes previously. Even if it's like a hard class and the professor is not great at teaching, I am okay with putting in a few extra hours of study every week just to know what's going on. And that's what I've been doing. Like, I've never reported a professor before. Like, I've always just independently resolved the issue myself. Like, I just study more, and it's okay. That's like, I'm okay with that. But with this professor, it's just not feasible at this point. So pretty much, he expects us to do all the textbook reading, and then there's like, okay, take the last exam that we took last week. This past week, for example, there were 7 chapters on there, so each chapter has like 20, 30 or so like pages. That's like a lot of reading to do, guys, and it's text. Like, this stuff I have to read several times sometimes, because like, I would read it, my brain would just not focus, and then it's just like you have to reread it to actually like comprehend what's going on. And also, he provides zero exam prep, so for all my other classes, they provide, if not one study, like one practice exam, like up to 3 practice exams. This guy didn't do that at all, and he pretty much, he also didn't say like, okay, these problems are important in the textbook to look at. He's just like, do as many of the textbook problems as you can, because I don't want to provide you a practice exam or point out specific questions, because those can't 100% encompass what I could possibly test you on. So I don't want to quote unquote misguide you and have you focus on certain topics and not others, and have like the ones that you didn't focus on end up on the test, and have you then come to me and be like, hey, why didn't you tell me that this was going to be on the exam, because this wasn't on the practice you gave us. So that's the reasoning he gave as to why he didn't want to provide any sort of exam guide, which is BS. You're just lazy. You're too lazy to write a practice exam for us. And like, you could totally encompass everything that you could ask on the exam, on the practice. So he doesn't do that. Instead, he's like, do as many textbook problems as you can. And guys, there's taking the last exam as like an example. There were 7 chapters, right? Each chapter has like 50 questions. So he's saying like, do as many of the 350 questions as you can. Like, that is not possible, professor, that is not possible. And because it's tax, it's really specific. It's always like word problems or like calculations, and it's like very specific tax laws a lot of times. So, and it also can change depending on your income bracket and like the year that the question is taking place in. So like, if you're like this income bracket, then these set of laws could apply to you, and like, these are the calculations you do. But if you're like in this income bracket, another set of laws can apply, and like, another type of calculation is done. Yeah. And he was like, yeah, you guys are going to be confused. And people were confused because someone asked him a question. Actually, like, four or five people had the same question about this, like, topic, and they were trying to get him to clarify. And he couldn't understand what people were asking. And it took, like, 20 minutes of people just literally trying to get him to understand what they were asking for. And when he, like, couldn't get what people were asking, he said something like, oh, in my, like, 30 or 40 years of teaching, I've never had anyone ask me this particular question because I think it's super straightforward and I'm teaching it super straightforwardly and we aren't even on the confusing part yet. And, like, that is so discouraging. And then I was sitting, like, kind of near the people that were asking this question. So, like, after they just, like, couldn't get him to understand what they were saying, they just gave up and they were like, yeah, we'll just figure it out on our own, which, like, is not right. Like, students should be able to ask their professor any sort of question and have it be answered, especially when it's, like, a new topic. And because he's terrible at budgeting his time, he ended up not finishing everything that was going to be on the exam, so he gave, like, quote-unquote optional office hours later on Tuesday. I think it was on Tuesday. Yeah, it was on Tuesday evening at, like, 5 p.m. Mind you, he was late. He was, like, 15 minutes late. Everyone was there waiting for him at 5:15 p.m. And he made it optional, but obviously it's not optional because it's, like, a new topic. And unless you want to be screwed on an exam, you have to go and learn it. And I'm, like, with every other professor I've had, even the ones that I didn't really like, if they didn't have time to talk about certain topics, they would just omit it from the exam. They would just, like, not test it because it's not fair to the student to, like, rush through a topic and still expect them to understand the material as if you had gone through it thoroughly. But yeah, that's, like, another thing that's really annoying. And, okay, since I'm, like, uncomfortable asking him questions in person, I figured that, hey, I could email him, right? And this guy, he refuses to answer emails on the weekend, even if it's the weekend before an exam. And he said that, like, he literally said that. So, which, okay, yeah, it's within your right to not answer emails on the weekend because I guess it's, like, still work and, you know, like, reasonable working hours, right? So, yeah, that's, like, okay, even though I don't totally agree with it because all my other professors have, like, answered emails on the weekend, like, albeit not as frequently, and it'll take, like, longer to get a response, but they will still get back to me. But yeah, since he doesn't, like, respond to emails on the weekends, I email him during the school week. But guess what, guys? I've emailed him 3 times so far this semester. He has responded to 0, 0, okay? He's responded to none of my emails. And, you know, if it was just one email going unresponded, you know, that could be an honest mistake. But 3, 3, that's intentional, okay? That's intentional. And it's actually offensive. And, okay, and also the first exam was 28 multiple choice questions. And everyone was seated. The class is like an hour 50. So you have like an hour and 50 minutes to do the exam. And up until the hour and 50, everyone was seated trying to finish, like, the exam. Nobody turned it in early. And I always sit in the back, so, like, I could see if anyone gets up early. Nobody was getting up early. Nobody turned it in early. And even despite that, he still decided to add more questions on the second exam. And he wouldn't tell us how many more questions he was asking. Like, when he said, oh, I'm gonna, like, add more questions on the second exam because the first one's, like, you know, the first one and you guys might not understand the format yet and I want to get you guys, like, used to the exam first. And okay, so I was thinking you're gonna add more questions, so maybe you bump it up from 28 to 30 or, like, from 28 to 32. No, he bumped it up to 38. He added 10 questions, guys, and the time limit was still the same. We still had to do it within an hour and 50 minutes. And this time everything was harder. We had harder topics this time. And I had like 4 or 5 questions at the end that I didn't have time for. And if it was still 28, like, I had so much panic. I wasn't the only one. Like, after the exam, so many people were like, oh my god, like, five or six questions, or like a bunch of questions left that I didn't, like, have time to finish. Which is, like, totally not fair. And it's really not fair that he didn't tell us the number of questions that he was adding. And I guess he himself knew that it was gonna be bad if, and people would, like, get mad if he told them that he was gonna add 10 questions, so he didn't tell us. But guys, he added 10 questions, and, like, I'm so upset. Like, I'm actually so upset. And going back to the point where I was saying that I've never reported a professor before, like, this time is my first time, and it might be my only time in college ever reporting a professor. And I actually got this idea from an acquaintance that's in the same class, and she told me that if enough people report him to the advisor, the department will actually, oh my god, I can't speak, the department will do an intervention. So, and usually when I email my advisor, like in the past, for like scheduling issues, she gets back to me within the day, but this time she took like over a day to get back to me. So I emailed her on Thursday, she got back to me Friday afternoon, like almost at 5 p.m. and, or like in the afternoon, maybe like a little bit earlier than like near 5, but it was like over a day since I sent my initial email. And this acquaintance had emailed the advisor, we have the same advisor, she had emailed our advisor on Monday, and she also didn't get a response until Friday, which is like a whole week later. Like, it took the whole week for her to get a response, which makes me think that a lot of people were emailing the advisor, and there was actually like some communication going on between our advisor and the department, which is why she took so long to get back to us. Because for this acquaintance, she also said that she gets responses usually within a day for like other issues in the past. So yeah, a lot of people probably reported him, and everyone has to take a tax and audit like at the same time, or like that's what they recommend you to do. And in both of these classes, people are always complaining about this tax professor. So yeah, I don't know when I'm uploading this video, because I have like a bunch of videos pre-filmed. But yeah, I'm currently going through it, guys. I don't know like what's gonna happen. In my email I wrote that I'm not comfortable having like a full-on confrontation with this guy. Call me a pussy, you know, call me whatever you want to call me, but this guy is just like so rude, and I can't take it. And I told them that what I'm seeking from this intervention is for him to provide like still watching. Thank you so much.